Join us on an adventure as CanadaDocks travels over 900 kilometers to transport a new dock kit to the Watson's Windy Point Lodge in Wawa, Ontario. We started our journey in Beaton, Ontario at the CanadaDocks head office. We loaded over 380 square feet of docks onto our trucks and our crew set out for the 10-hour drive that laid ahead of us. To get there, we drove north along Georgian Bay past Sudbury to Sault Ste. Marie, then north along Lake Superior to Wawa, Ontario. There aren't many dock companies that are able to make this trek, not because it's a far distance, but because of what we faced when we got to Wawa. Windy Point Lodge is a fly-in only fishing camp. There are so many fishing camps in Northern Ontario, and they face challenges to transport large, bulky items into camp easily. This is where CanadaDocks makes this process easy. All of our products are packaged into an 8x1 foot long box, which makes it extremely simple to load into a float plane. The total weight of all these docks was around 3,800 pounds. Two 8x16 floating docks, one 4x16 floating dock, and one 4x16 floating ramp. This only required two plane trips, with enough room for our four crew members and all of their gear. With that said, we're off to Windy Point Lodge.
Third generation on Cape Nakagami Lake.
And I'm Stephanie.
Well, this is known as Windy Point Lodge. We operate 9 cabins on a fly-in only lake. It's a 25-mile long lake known for walleye, pike, perch, and whitefish. Probably the best way to reach out to us is windypointlodge.com, and we'll follow us on Facebook as well. This lodge was originally built in 1967. My grandfather started the first lodge on this lake in 1946. We had the chance to purchase this lodge back in 2013 and took it over and just completely rebuilt everything on it. 9 cabins, we operate American Plan now, which operates all your, have all your food, and you can also do your housekeeping plan if you want to do your own cooking. Our most occupancy levels, 55. On average, we're usually around 30-35 people, running anywhere between 18 and 20 boats. Probably the most challenging part could be the weather. Mother Nature dictates what we do, either for flying or late ice out or high water levels, low water levels. But it's all part of the adventure. You never know what you're going to see up here. I'll guarantee fish, I'll never guarantee weather. Lots of walleyes, records, 214 walleyes off the dock in 8 hours by 4 guys. So, like, compared to like when it's May and June, we're on a natural spawning ground. You know, you're going to get a lot of fish around that time of the year, but they just migrate. And you don't have to go very far, as the walleye's prime beginning of the season. And then as we start getting into August, we're going to be looking at a lot of perch fishing. Sure. And then you know, they just move, like you said. Ask the guys who live up here, we have a pretty good idea where they are.
The lightweight structure of CanadaDocks systems ensures that we kept costs down and were able to load and unload very quickly.
On average, everything we fly in is about 80 cents a pound is our cost extra, to, as long as it fits in a plane. And if not, we've done a lot of loads through helicopters too. It's a 60-mile flight. We fly out of Wawa, Ontario, and it's all part of the adventure. Yeah, I was really surprised how easy it was. I was building different variations, trying to see what would work, and looking at the weights, as the sizes of everything, and seeing the, you know, everything. I think the biggest box that came in was maybe 50 pounds, 8 feet long. It was great. It was, for us, for loading and unloading, it was perfect. Anytime you factor in an aircraft and seeing how long this dock actually is, and the fact that everything fit in on two planes is amazing. And then how fast it went together, when you start factoring in labor every day and anywhere you can save, it adds up really quick up here.
I was pretty impressed.
Speed of build, the very minimal waste afterwards is, you know, when you're in the middle of the bush, you gotta watch for that kind of stuff.
We went with a floating dock system, given that this lake sees a drastic variation in water levels throughout the season. The floating structure allows the dock to adjust to the water levels easily. And with the large waves that come through, the through-flow decking installed on top of the docks ensure that the water can move through the dock itself. It's a stable system, and it can definitely withstand the elements up here. Some of the advantages of a modular dock system is that it can be easily installed and seasonally removed. Especially up here, with the amount of ice that moves on this lake, you definitely need to remove it for winter.
That's the nice thing we're looking at, is to remove a couple pins, float it over the shore. We have a couple of guys, probably four guys, each grab a corner, lift it up. I think the biggest piece, like 8x16, weighed 600 pounds. Yep. A guy on each corner, pull it up, and in the event, you know, you could also use a couple planks on the ground, and you hook it up to a four-wheeler and back it up and put it in a nice, safe place. And, you know, it's only four pieces. We'll be done in no time. Come out in the spring, hook it back up, and that's it.